Hey, we're cooking Sunday supper. We want to encourage you to just reimagine the kitchen and how you can have Sunday suppers with your family, with friends, invite people over. And I'm trying to give you as easy as possible.
Why did you look at me when you said that?
Because I just want to acknowledge you're here.
Thank you.
Okay. Do you do Sunday suppers?
Sometimes. It depends on whether everybody's there or not. At my house, they're often
gone on Sunday.
Well, sometimes. Depends. Right. But we try to.
But if you had this kind of food, would they
be there? Or be square.
They'd be there, right?
Yeah, they all call about 3:30 and say, what's for dinner?
Food is a tremendous attractor of people.
Yes, it is.
And if you feed them, they will come.
What are we cooking today?
Today, we're going to have Eye of Round. Ooh. We're going to have what I call my ultimate scallop potatoes. And we're going to have a pea and caramelized onion recipe. And for dessert, we're going to have a wonderful apple tart.
Okay.
All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
Eye of Round. Now, a lot of people cook their meat at very high temperatures. You hear that a lot?
Yes,
I do.
And
you set it up to 400 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of came to this gradually, that it's much better to cook low and slow.
Okay. So what do you do, this 325 or?
I actually do it at 200.
No way.
Yeah. And you'll see the result.
For 2 weeks or
no? No. For it's an hour and a half cooking time total for a 3-pound.
Really? Wow, that's amazing.
And your prep time is really easy. First, take your cut. You take salt. I've got about a teaspoon and a half here. And you just sprinkle. This is sea salt. I like the flavor it comes. You sprinkle this all over. Then you take some pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Do the same. Make sure you get a coating. Then you're going to take some olive oil, and this is what the thyme is going to adhere to.
Ah.
And then you take the thyme, and in a classic rub, what gets it its name is you're not sprinkling, but you're doing that.
Ah.
You're actually getting your hand on it, and you're rubbing it in, and you're getting everything all happy. You turn it over and do the same. This becomes your top, and some Eye of Round comes completely trimmed. This is a very lean piece of meat, so if you have the fat, it'll add more flavor to it. So
how easy is that? You do this whole thing on both sides, that what you just
did. Right.
Okay.
How easy is that?
That's easy.
Is that easy?
That's easy.
Okay. Put it on a rack. Put it in the oven. That's a 3-pound cut, 20 minutes a pound at 200, and then you turn the oven off.
Oh, and you leave it in there.
And you leave it in there for another half an hour.
Okay.
And this comes out. Now, how I get color when you're cooking it this low is you take that first into a heavy saucepan and 3 minutes aside at very high heat, and that gives it this color, and then you cook it low and slow.
Okay.
And it comes out looking like this. And then when you carve it, what you get is medium rare all the way through.
That's perfect.
So the sear colors it, sears it down just a quarter inch, and then you get a perfect color all the way through.
Is that a
now that looks good. That's horseradish.
That horseradish sauce. Oh, yes. Okay.
All right. That's one dish. That's easy.
That's perfect.
It's mostly in the oven.
After you do a little bit of prep work, you're
done.
Hands free.
Okay.
Okay.
Next is scallop potatoes, and I call this the ultimate scallop potato. This actually takes a lot of work.
So you need them as thin as you can get them, right?
What I do is I break out a trusty mandolin. This is a great piece of kitchen equipment. It's not that expensive. And instead of being labor intensive, you just use that over the guard. Put this here. And
wow. I vote for that. That's
and
great.
Half a potato gets knocked out.
And you really
in
got
15
nice
seconds.
Thin slices.
And each slice will be uniform.
Mm-hmm.
That ends up looking like this in a bowl. And you come over here. You're not trying to be fancy with this because it's all going to be covered by cheese and cream. You just want to space it out in the bottom. And you're going to have so many potatoes, you're going to create 4 layers of this. All right? Simple so far?
Mm-hmm. So far, so
here comes a complicated step. You take leeks.
Mm-hmm.
You ever had vichyssoise?
Yeah, love vichyssoise.
What I've done is combined the flavors of vichyssoise and put them in with scalloped potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
Where you take cream and the white part of the leek, you take these into a saucepan with a little bit of butter, and you just sweat them. You try to get some of the flavor out just in the butter. Okay. And then you take 3 cups of cream, heavy whipping cream. So this is not
a low-cal.
This is a, we are trying to hit the home run on this dish. Put it all in a blender, and you're trying to take these down to a smooth consistency so you won't ever bite into a piece of leek. You just get the flavor.
Okay.
You're trying to create sort of a mini vichyssoise sauce to go into the potatoes. Then I've got 3 different cheeses, Romano, Parmesan, and Gruyere. You put the Romano on first, and this whole quarter cup goes the first layer. Try to do it evenly. You then put another layer of potatoes on. You pour on the cream, then a layer of Gruyere, another layer of potatoes and cream, layer of Parmesan, another layer of potatoes, the final bit of cream, and then you press it all down to make sure the cream
literally
is gone everywhere with your hands. And then do the final layer of Gruyere on top, and that melts and creates something beautiful.
Wow. And then you call Jenny Craig. Whoa. Okay.
It took me years to develop this recipe. I kept experimenting, and this is at the end of all my experiments. Mm. I've done some others where you use roasted garlic in it, too. If you want to experiment, roasted garlic is a good experiment.
Mm-hmm.
This is sweet peas frozen with caramelized onions. And here's a trick that I learned actually from a restaurant chef. Never buy fresh pearl onions.
Okay.
Because it's so labor intensive to take them, take the skins off. If you buy them frozen, they're already peeled for you.
Oh, that's great.
And so you just get them in the freezer section. And you get the peas in the freezer section. Frozen peas are always better than fresh because the fresh is never really as fresh as they say it is. And the two combine together into something beautiful. You take the pearl onions, put them in a heavy skillet with 1/2 tablespoon of sugar, and you cook it at a medium heat.
You just keep moving them around.
You keep moving them around until the sugar caramelizes on the outside.
That's beautiful.
And you get that beautiful look. And these are caramelized pearl onions. And this is a taste treat. You get the onion flavor, but that sugar.
Yes.
And it comes in caramelized, and it's wonderful. This
it looks wonderful.
Is really good. Now, here's a French secret. You take the peas, you pour it in, again, 1/2 tablespoon of sugar.
Really?
In the peas with 1/4 teaspoon of salt. With 1/2 stick of butter cut into small little pieces, and you just let it sit there for 2 hours and get happy.
It's looking real happy right
what
now.
What the sugar and the salt does
do?
Is it helps draw out the flavor from the pea, and it sweetens the pea, and then this is all you need to cook. Put 2 tablespoons of water in the bottom of the saucepan, pour this in there, cover it, stir it once in a while, and cook it for 15, 20 minutes. And it will be beautiful and sweet and fully cooked. The real calling card for this, kids love to eat these.
I was just going to say, this could make a child who's not a veggie eater
just will love them. And you combine the caramelized pearl onions with the peas, and it looks beautiful and it tastes marvelous.
Fabulous.
This is one of the best. You ready to try it?
I am always ready to try it.
All right, I'm going to get you some warm potatoes to go with all of this.
Move this, maybe under here.
And
oh, look at that. Wow. No wonder you make your own scalloped potatoes.
We had scalloped potatoes growing up. It was one of my favorite things for Mom to cook for me, and I just loved them and thought that they were wonderful.
I like them, too. I haven't had them, when I think about it, since I was a kid, I don't think. Can I taste that first?
Yeah. Mm. But the Gruyere really adds the flavor with the Parmesan, the Romano.
Oh, wow.
That's a wow.
That's like layers of flavor.
Yeah.
Excellente. Okay.
All right, you're going to go for a
caramelized onion with the peas. Oh, that's a great combination.
Isn't that good?
Mm-hmm.
And with the roast, it really adds a whole nother flavor profile to it. Make sure you slice it thin. You don't want a thick slice because eye of round can get a little tough. Here's one of my favorites. This is a French dessert.
That's delicious, Gordon.
And the French really know how to do tarts. And it's a real simple one. It's a simple crust you make for yourself. You don't bake it in a pie pan. You just put it on a cooking sheet. You roll it out into a circle, and you crimp up the edges.
Really?
You take a couple of Granny Smiths. Mm-hmm. You take them. You peel them. You core them. You cut them in half, and then you slice thin. You just create a circle around the edge, and then you fill in the center to make it look like a flower. And this is a crowd pleaser. And you serve this with a scoop of ice cream warm, and you'll have them coming back for more.
Wow.
And then you finish it with some apricot jam, thin with a little bit of water, and that gives it that beautiful sheen.
Wow.
The apples coming out of the oven will look a little brown. When you put the apricot jam on top, it just gives it a beautiful thing. It really, really works. It really, really works. All of these recipes are available on CBN.com. They're available right now. You can download them, and you can do the prep work necessary. This one takes a little more prep time than the other meals we've been showing you, but it's worth the effort. And once you taste those scalloped potatoes, you understand just how big of a wow this can be. So do it this weekend. Say, we're going to have some food of love on Sunday. We're going to have an old-fashioned Sunday dinner with roast beef and scalloped potatoes.
Yum.